What's going on, y'all? Machiavelli Meals TV. And I'm gonna start this off by saying this, man. If any one of y'all is viewing my video right now are huge French Montana fans, I'm gonna ask you politely to exit the video immediately, because I know you're not gonna like nothing that I'm saying on this video. And that's okay. That's okay. I'm perfectly fine with that. But I gotta speak my truth, and I'm sorry this might hurt your feelings. But French Montana is trash. Like, he is a terrible rapper. Ain't nothing nice about French. He ain't got no charisma to even let him get away with some of the stuff he be saying on tracks. Like, it's not acceptable. He is boo-boo. He is dumpster juice. And really what made me really just make this video is that I'm listening to the Joe Budden podcast, right? And I'm listening to Rory, Maul, and Joe talk about French's album that came out at the top of December, right? And so they talking about how after the album was out for like only a week or a week and a half, French up there bragging and boasting on videos talking about his gold album. He got a gold plaque, his album gold already. He got a gold plaque for an album that been out like a damn week. And I'm like, how the hell is this album already gold? He got a gold plaque printed out already. They're like, cut it out. And I'm looking like, I paused everything. I stopped the video to go look at the track listing for this album. And I promise y'all, I figured out what the hell French be doing. Like, French be out here finessing his way to make it seem like he doing something that he really not doing. Like, he really not, like, he try to finesse his way to make it seem like he doing something he not doing. I promise y'all, I looked at this track list. The track list ain't got like 4 songs from like 3 years ago. 3-4 years ago. And he included that on this album because he knows that they count streams for singles as album sales. And if people is listening to them popular songs with Drake on it, the No Shopping, the No Stylist, and the Lockjaw with Kodak Black, if people streaming them songs, it's going to make it look like his album is just doing bananas because the streams count as sales, which I think is just corny, and they need to get that up out of the rap game, because it's causing a lot of dudes to have inflated egos and make it seem like, you know, they just like they top dog or something out here. Like French do, like French really think he really like he just the coldest artist out, and he gotta cut it out, fam, because everybody and their mama know French has never ever been able to hold his own on a track by himself. Like, he ain't never been like that. I'm sorry. And people always go back and say, well, you got to listen to his older mixtapes with Harry Fraud and all of that. His older mixtapes with Harry Fraud. Cut it out. Because you know and I know the production carried French on them song, on them mixtapes. The production alone carried French. French ain't got no charisma, like, on the song at all. Like, he just be saying anything. He just be, like, just trying to, like, he be trying to swag his way through a verse. And I do not like rappers that do that. Fam, if you gonna rap. Put some words together. That's your profession. Like, try to, like, put some words together. Formulate something dope. Don't just be out here just throwing, watch the body drop when you hit the head. Thinking about how I'm gonna call the feds. Like, no. Like, stop it, fam. Like, nah. And then I'm thinking, like, I'm like, man, his album got all these streams to afford to go gold. They got to be playing my man's songs in warehouses or like steel mills or something. They just blasting it, streaming it all in steel mills and warehouses. Well, people don't hear it but workers, because we ain't hearing it. I'm not hearing nobody bump his album. I'm living in Chicago, Illinois. I ain't heard a person yet bump French album at all for him to have a gold album. Like, I'm like, dude be out here finessing his way through the industry. And for real, and it helps that he co-signed with Diddy. Diddy probably be making all the folks at the Revolt sweatshop. at the Revolt office, they be making phone calls to just stream French's music in Nike sweatshops or whatever, to make it seem like he just be selling out of the stores, like French just doing crazy numbers. Fam, it ain't nobody listening to that album, I promise y'all. Like, I promise y'all, it's all smoke and mirrors. The same way when they said French had a number one song with that Unforgettable with Swae Lee. Now, I will add, the song became, it grew on me, it became catchy only because of Swae Lee's hook and his melodies. That's it. Like, and it was like, it was a number one hit. It was like, it's number one. And I remember I was watching my man's Dead End Hip Hop, Mike C-Town and Ken and all of them and FIFO. And they like, that song, they saying it's a number one hit. But who the hell is playing that song? They didn't even, they live in Atlanta and they wasn't even hearing that damn song being played. I wasn't hearing it being played in Chicago. It was only getting all them plays on YouTube. And I'm thinking, damn, was they buying views on YouTube like that? Even though the video was dope because they had the kids in Africa getting down. But I'm looking like, they tell me this is a number one hit. Yeah, it's catchy, but nobody was even playing a song. And they're like, it's a number one smash hit. I'm like, how the hell is this going on? Like, nobody even playing this song. But here, like, French always be able to do this. And I be thinking in my head, I don't know how, is he plugged? Do he got pictures on somebody? He got pictures on somebody in the industry. Do he got pictures on Diddy and all of that? Diddy be promoting him and pushing him? And French ain't not like, he was never that man's. He got, like, he really, really got his whole little, like, style, and he got his own little persona. He was doing the DVDs at first, but he even got his whole persona and even his status, or whatever you want to call it, in a rap game by standing next to Max B, Bigger Veil, Boss Don, Bigger Veil. That's for real. Because on his own, he ain't never been able to hold his own weight. That's why he go get all the hottest artists in the game. He had a 30, he'd have a 25-second verse, a 20-second verse, and have three other artists that's the hottest artist in the game on a song, and it'll say French Montana featuring 4 or 5 different artists, and it'll say it's his song. When you don't even remember the damn verse from French, you don't know what the hell French said or nothing. You just remember Drake verse. You remember A$AP Rocky verse. You remember Rick Ross verse. You don't remember nothing. You don't remember nothing that French said. And I'd be like, he keep getting all these favors from artists. He keep getting all these features. Do he got pictures on these dudes? Like, is he tied in to somebody that putting pressure on dudes to tell people, do he got, like, some type of ties or relationship that, like, with somebody that's telling these artists, hey, do a song with French. You better do a song with French. Because I'm like, fam, how the hell Drake keep giving him favors? French can't be that nice of a dude, because I used to think he must be a really cool dude. But he can't be that nice of a dude, for real. Because ain't no much generosity in the world. You keep getting on a song with somebody that just be rapping like that over and over again. Like, the machine must be powerful behind French or something. Because it don't make no sense. The man is doctoring, finessing on his way to a gold single, a gold album, by adding these old songs. Old song. Lockjaw. Fam, Lockjaw came out 4 years ago. 3 years ago. Fam, cut it out. No, it is. No, what is it? No Shopping came out 3 years ago. No Stylist came out a whole year ago. And he know that people got Drake, that people love Drake. So they're going to accidentally play the song if they're not playing it in the warehouse or the factories or the steel mills or whatever. If they're not streaming it in there for all the co-workers, all the workers to just be listening to it. They don't even want to hear it. If somebody just happens to love Drake and they just want to hear something with Drake on it, that stream from that song would get credited to French for an album sale. Like, yeah, they gotta stop that, cause that's just corny, and it's leading these dudes to have bigger egos than what they should have. Cause French think he that dude on that music tip, and he just ain't like that. He ain't never been like that, for real. Like, I'm like, what do French do that's so spectacular to make him nice? Cause I don't be hearing it, y'all. I'm sorry, and I know my people from New York City, they're probably watching this video. It's a lot of people from New York. It's a couple people, I think, from New York that may have subscribed to this channel. I'm sorry, y'all. Look, I promise y'all, if y'all say Chief Keef garbage, I wouldn't be mad at y'all. By my personal preference, because Keef from the crib, I grew up, you know, listening to the sounds that they was making or whatever. So Keef, I like the hits that Keef made or whatever. So you can say Keef garbage. It's cool, whatever. I'm sorry, New York people, though. I don't feel nothing that French be doing. I don't. And his whole, he always been a dude that's an opportunist. He only dated Khloe Kardashian because he know that it was going to put him in, he was going to introduce him to a wider audience that he didn't have before. He knew if he dated Khloe and he stood next to a Kardashian, it was going to introduce him to a whole new audience that was just going to clamor to him and make him more popular than what he was. Like, you feel me? Like, that's the only reason he did that. Everything about him is clout chaser. Right? And I remember when Dirk, I always say this, I remember when Gucci first got out of jail. Around the time Gucci first got out of jail, he made an album. At the time, Lil Durk, an artist that's from Chicago, Illinois, was affiliated with French and Coke Boys movement. Durk was on his second studio album that was coming out, Lil Durk 2X, two times, right? And French did not promote that boy album at all. But as soon as Gucci get out of jail, French promoting Gucci album like it ain't nothing. Because French wanted that look so bad. He was dying to be standing next to Gucci to get that look, to get certified. I want a single with Gucci. I want a song with Gucci. He was just that thirsty to get on a song with Gucci that he forgot about his little man's Dirt. Like, hey, man, Dirt, get your ass out the way. Get out the way. Get the hell out the way, Dirk. I want to stand at the Gucci. Right, and I remember Dirk wasn't even tripping, but when they asked him at the Breakfast Club, like, you were Coke Boys, French Show, y'all still cool, right? And one of the DJ Envy or Angela Yee or something, like, why French ain't promote your album? And Dirk was like, I don't really know, man. I don't really know what's up with that. I don't really know. And DJ Vans, Dirk DJ, was like, he shouted Gucci shit out, though. He shouted Gucci stuff out, which he did. Because French is nothing but an opportunist, man, for real. Straight up, man. I'd be like, come on, fam. And I don't, like, he be trying to make it seem like he doing something so profound. Like, it's just not it. I don't understand the whole movement, the whole clamor for dude. I just don't get it. Like, I really don't. But, yeah, man, like, people be like, you got to listen to his old stuff. Again, Harry Fraud, the production that Harry Fraud was providing French, was carrying French through and through. And it's no secret. But, like, all of it, like, come on, fam. Like, The Unforgettable was not on number one single. They was not playing it in the shot. And when FIFO and Mike C. Town and Ken and all of them from Dead End Hip Hop said they wasn't even hearing it like that in Atlanta, Georgia. That told me that's a music central for all the big hits. They wasn't even hearing that. So that let me know I wasn't tripping. The song was catchy, but it just wasn't bubbling like that. But the Billboard was saying French was just so hot. I'm like, who the hell is listening to that song for real? I was never hearing nobody play it around me. None of my friends was playing it. Nobody was playing it. Like, I'm like, what the? Nobody was playing. My homie Melvin ain't never even heard the damn No Shopping song. I don't even remember the No Shopping song. I don't remember that. I don't, like, so... Yeah, man, but, like, fam, I know it sounds like I'm just going in on French, but, fam, like, what do he do? What? So I promise you, I hate rappers that try to swag their way through a verse, because French don't got enough charisma to even do that. He don't. All that hang throwing at Montana. That's not enough ad-libs, boss. That's not enough to get you through this song play. You have to provide something else. But I just feel, I'm like, he got a gold album. Like, stop, hold the presses. Him having them old ass songs on his album is equivalent to 50 Cent dropping a new album with In the Club and Candy Shop on there. Like, of course it's gonna boost your sales. People are always listening to In the Club all the time. It's somebody's birthday every day, so they gonna play It's Your Birthday, which will equal out to an album sale for 50, which is cheating. Like, come on, fam. Like, you can't be out here. Like what? Just imagine if 50 did that. 50 made a new album, had Candy Shop, In the Club, Disco Inferno. Come on, like, really? Really, fam? We can't, 21 Questions, all that on there. And we just gonna, like, oh, it, like, we gonna act like, oh, you went gold off some hot shit. Like, nah, bro, your whole, most of your track list is from 4 years ago. Song singles that you had 4 years ago on YouTube. You trying to re-release the single with the album? Like, who y'all think y'all fooling, man? Like, nah, man. Diddy pushing the machine, though, and he into it 50 right now, too. Hey, real talk, though, because I'm hating on French on this tip right now, because I'm trying to get in shape and get my body right so my girl can, you know what I'm saying, like my body, too, whatever. I'm like, did French go to Dr. Miami to get his abs, bro? Did he go to Dr. Miami and get his abs and get the procedure done when he was in the hospital, man? I don't know. Like, my man's woke up with abs all out of nowhere, and he acting like he trying to just show he in the hospital. My man's flexing his abs in a picture that's intended to show that he's recovering in the hospital. He doing his Instagram model pose, though. Like, I'm like, bro, get French up out of here, man. Like, man. Like, when Marlon was talking about this on the Breakfast Club. I'm sorry. When Marlon was talking about this on the Joe Budden podcast, I had to just stop the interview and, like, let me go to this track list. Let me see what's on this album that is gold. Like, who on here? And I see them old-ass songs on there. I'm like, bro, he got to cut it out, bro. He got to relax, brother. He needs to relax all the way. And Diddy needs to tell him to relax, too, man. that's it on this, man. Machiavelli Meals TV. Thank y'all for rocking with me. Tune in. Like this video. Subscribe to the channel. Share my videos. I appreciate all the comments, all the support. I appreciate y'all. Thanks for rocking with me. Peace.